So guys, welcome to Goose Lightning Reactions. We're here for episode 2 of Tensai Shitara Slime Dateken, or when the time I was reincarnated as a slime, something like that. Let's see if this continues from how good episode 1 was. 131, 3, 2, 1, go. I'm hoping it's more similar to the beginning of the series, the episode, rather than the second half. Oh my god, why is there a Tsundere dragon? It's emanating from him? Yeah, I knew he'd say that. He's trying to act cool. Try what? Yeah, that would be difficult. Talking to your own skill. But you have to get inside, you might get trapped, right? Can you feel my eyes rolling into the back of my head? Interesting suggestion. Kind of want this part to be over with, honestly. We are equals, a slime and a dragon. Name him Slime Son. That's a good name. It's not the Edimid.
What?
What a budding friendship. That's crazy, honestly. So you can just carry him away. Can they talk to each other still? Would they have sensed that this happened? Bloomund. These are some strange looking fellows. Their mouths are like way down near their chins. Okay, not the most interesting scene. It'd be slow goings. Oh shit. I gotta learn this shit real quick. Water manipulation. You just cut off its head or let it talk. That was easy. He absorbed that head. There's some poison. Poisonous breath, heat source. Well, I see these mimic skills and yeah, he should have gotten some skills from getting Veldra inside him, right?
It's all because he wanted to get as many women as he wanted, as he could in the afterlife, which is crazy. There's the mimic. Death. Eat him. Oh. Paralysis. Yo, this dude is about to get overpowered. Having a lot of abilities is great, but keeping track of all of them is rough. How big is this cave? The outside world, finally. Is this the invading army? Could be. We gotta keep this in context that there was a. Yo, they're gonna try to attack him. This is a middle-aged man right here. No magic sense. Convenient. You need to. That's a nice skill to have. Perfection. Did you go out to exit? Goblin time. Yo, they're scared as hell. Yeah, talk to him. Strong one. How do they know he's strong? He sensed it. And help out the goblins? A village. To the elder. Elder? That was a month ago? But he is. About to be freaking crazy. That's kind of crazy.
Wow.
Yeah, good thing. Otherwise, they would have tried to attack you or something. Actually, they wouldn't have seen him. They're idiots. No. He passed away, huh? All they got is this old ass dude and a bunch of weaklings. Need 1,000 goblins to take care of that. The next elder in line. Nothing. Gratitude? Yeah. Testing them. Loyalty. Wow. They came straight for him. I accept.
Interesting. All right. So I gotta say, I had a really, really large cooldown from this episode. Incredibly so. So we'll see next episode. I'm gonna give it at least one more episode. Obviously, if this comes out, I probably continued all the way through, but I'm just taking into account of what I'm feeling right now. I think once the novelty of the systems and stuff wore off after that first episode, I was looking for, like, characterization, recurring characters. Isekai is a really, you know, a dime a dozen. I mean, not a dime a dozen. That's the opposite, isn't it? Anyways, there are a lot of isekai, so you know, you really want something different from this genre. I mean, it was kind of fun to watch him take all those skills in, learning all the way. But I'm trying to look for, you know, I'm pretty sure there's an entire cast that ends up traveling with him, at least from the front cover of the actual series. I'd like to see how those characters are and if it's something that I would enjoy watching. From that perspective, and I want to see his actual interaction with humans. So, those are my current thoughts, and we'll see what happens next time. Hopefully, you guys enjoyed this. If you did, please like and subscribe. As always, was that English? Please like and subscribe. As always, thank you for watching. See you guys next time. Bye.